Hi everyone, this is Pawan. Welcome to Technical Knowledge Family. I'm a data warehousing and business intelligence trainer and I train on different technologies, Informatica, Teradata, Tableau, Unix and shell scripting. In this video, we'll try to learn SED command in Unix. If you want to make your career in IT industry and if you want career-oriented videos, then kindly subscribe to our channel Technical Knowledge. We'll keep on posting technical videos and career-guiding videos that will be helpful for all of you to grow in your career, right? So let's directly jump to our screen and let's try to understand SED command in Unix. First, we'll try to understand why to use SED command, in which scenario we have to use SED command, and what is the syntax of SED command. Let's try to understand why to use SED command. First of all, what is the full form of SED? SED means stream editor. So that means if you want to edit any of the file in Unix, or if you want to print something from your file, or if you want to find and replace something in your file. So basically, if you want to do any editing in your file, then we'll have to use SED command. Alright? But all this editing can also be done via VI editor, right? So what is the difference between VI editor and SED command or stream editor? In VI editor, you have to open your file and then you can do your editing. But in stream editor, that is your SED, you do not have to open your file, you just have to pass the file name and your file will be edited. So that is why it is called stream editor. Now we'll try to understand the syntax of SED command. In my every video, as I say, that to understand any of the command, first the basic syntax should be clear. If the basic syntax is very clear, then it will be easy for you to understand any of the command. So what is the syntax of SED command? SED, of course, and then option, whatever option you want to specify, you have to specify that option. After that, in inverted quote, you have to specify your address, on which address you want to perform something, and after that, which action you want to perform onto that particular address. Then inverted quote is closed, and then of course your file name. So this is the basic syntax of SED command. If you understand the syntax, then it will be easy to run SED according to your requirement. Now we'll try to understand SED command with some practical usage. Okay, with some practical requirement. Now what is our first requirement? Our first requirement is, in a file, I want to print the first 10 lines of the file. So what will be the command? SED hyphen n is a option, right? Hyphen n is always used when you want to print something. Otherwise, that print will not behave correctly. So hyphen n is the option which has been used with p, that is your print. So inverted quote, you have to specify your address. I want to print the first 10 lines, so 1, 10, and then p of course is my action. Inverted quote is closed, and then your file name. Let's try to run this command in PuTTY. This is our first command. PuTTY is nothing but a terminal to connect in your Unix server. So I'm connected to my Unix server via PuTTY. Let's take a listing of the file. I have a file employee.txt. Let me show you the file first. I can see the file via VI editor. So this is the file. If you want to see the line number of the file, just give that command scape colon set and u, and you can see the line number of the file. If you want to go to the last of the file, just press shift G. You will be coming to the last line of the file. So we have 4046 number of records or number of lines in our employee.txt file. And if you can see in that employee.txt, we have couple of employees. Some of them are managers, some of them are HR, some of them are director. So accordingly, we will manipulate our file as per our requirement. If you want to go to the first line of the file, just press 1 capital G. Okay, I'm at my first line of the file. And if you want to just exit from this file, just press escape colon Q. Alright, so let us run the first command, that is to print the first 10 line of the file. scd-n1,10p employee.txt, that is my pipe name. So I can see the first 10 employees are printed on my terminal. So this is our first requirement. We'll try to understand scd command with practical usage so that you can use those practical scenarios in your project or in your companies, right? Now, what is our second requirement? Our second requirement is to print a different range of line. Like I want to print 1 to 5, then 10 to 15, then 21 to 24. So if I have that requirement that I want to print a different range of line from my file, then I will be using hyphen E option. Hyphen E option is used to give multiple instructions to scd command, right? Let us try to run this command. So what is the command? Scd hyphen E 1,5p hyphen E 10,15p hyphen E 21,24p and inverted quote is closed, then file name employee.txt. See, I have a different range of line printed on my terminal, right? This was my second requirement, to print different range of line. Now what is our third requirement? Our third requirement is want to print something on the basis of some pattern, right? We can achieve this task with context addressing. Now what is the context addressing? Now in my file I have a data related to different employees who are director, HR, manager, or I only want to print the employee detail who is director. So I can use context addressing. So the syntax to use context addressing is that you have to specify that particular pattern in forward slashes, inverted quote open forward slash that particular pattern, in my case the pattern is director, forward slash again, and then my action, that is P. Let us run this command. This is called context addressing. Let me clear my screen. See, I can only see the data related to director only. It has not given me the data for HR, it has not given me data for manager, it is only giving me data related to director only. Now, what is my fourth requirement? My fourth requirement is to find and replace something in file, or it is called substitution. This is one of the most important feature of scd command if you want to find and replace something in your file in Unix. Now what is my requirement? My requirement is I want to find all the director in my file and I want to replace that director with HR, right? So what will be the command? Scd in inverted quote, I'm using S. S stands for substitution. I am finding director, replacing with HR. So again I have to give that pattern into a forward slash and then I am giving a G. G stands for global. That means in my file, let's suppose director is coming twice or thrice, two times or three times or four times. So in every line, I want to replace each and every occurrence of director with HR. So I'll be using G. But let's suppose I only want to replace second occurrence of director in that particular line. So instead of G, I will give 2. So it will only replace the second occurrence. If I want to replace third occurrence of director in that particular line, then I will give 3. But I want to replace each and every occurrence of director in all the particular lines, then I have to specify G. G stands for global and S stands for substitution, right? So we were talking about our fourth requirement, that I want to replace a director with HR. Let us run this command. Let me clear my screen. Now how do I verify whether all the director have been replaced by HR or not? So the best practice is that instead of showing the output on the terminal, let's redirect the output to a file and let's give the name of the file as testing. Okay, now let us open that file, or let us take a listing of the file. I have that file which is called testing. And let me open that file. Now I cannot see any of the director in my file. If I want to, or if I try to search director in my file, I cannot see director because all the director have been replaced by HR in my file. I hope the fourth requirement is quite clear. That is the most important requirement, to find and replace something in your file. Now, what is the fifth requirement? The fifth requirement is, we only want to find and replace only first 10 lines or within the range of lines. I do not want to find and replace in my entire file. I only want to replace within the range of the file. So let's suppose I want to find and replace in first 10 line. So in address, I have to specify 1, 10. But let's suppose I want to replace or find and replace in first 20 lines, then I have to give 1, 20s. Right? This is how I can manipulate my address. Now let us run this command. Okay, in my first 10 line, I have replaced my director with HR. Right? This is how that command works. What is my next requirement? My next requirement is, find and replace something removing case sensitivity. So let's suppose that in my file, I have a director and that director is in small case. But I also have a director in my file which is not in small case, but the first letter is in capital. So I want to remove the case sensitivity. So it will replace that this spelling also, and it will replace that capital D, starts with capital D, that director also. So if I want to remove the case sensitivity, then I need to use I at the end, right? This is how you can remove the case insensitivity or case sensitivity while finding and replacing with I option. Now, what is my seventh requirement? My seventh requirement is, find and replace and redirect the output to a file. Okay, as I told you in my previous example also, that if you want to cross verify whether the substitution has happened or not, it's a good practice to redirect the output into a target file so that you can cross verify whether the substitution happens or not. Because in scd command, what basically happens is, you are finding and replacing in your file, but it is showing the output on your terminal, but it is not finding and replacing in your original file. Your original file is not modified. You are just seeing an output in your output terminal. But if you want to see that substitution, then you have to redirect that output into a target file. But this is how you can redirect the output in your target file. So what that command will do, that command will replace director with HR, and it will redirect the output of file called hr.txt. Now let me take a listing. I have that file hr.txt. Let me open that file. Okay, if I try to find out director in that file, I should not be getting director because I have replaced my director with HR. I cannot find director in my file, right? Now, what is our next requirement? Or within the seventh requirement, there is one more case, that if you want to find and replace in the original file, if you want to find and replace in your original file, then you have to use hyphen I option. Okay, what will be the command? Sed hyphen I. I want to replace all the directors with HR that to globally in the entire file with every occurrence. Right? Now let us run this command. If we are modifying in the original file itself, that is employee.txt, now there is no need to redirect that output into a target file because the original file itself is modified with the hyphen I option. Let us run this command. What is the command? Sed hyphen I, then substitute director with HR that to globally. Okay, now let us take listing. We have employee.txt. Now open that employee.txt in vi editor just to cross verify whether the substitution happens or not. Now if I try to find director in employee.txt, I will not get because my original file has been modified now. Alright. Now what is our next requirement? These all are the practical requirements which is frequently used in any of the project if you are working in Unix environment. The next requirement is find and replace in original file by taking a backup of original file. Okay, I want to find and replace in my original file, but before substitution, I want to have a backup. So if something goes wrong, at least I should be having some backup, right? So what will be the command? Sed, of course, hyphen I dot whatever extension you want to give. It's up to you. You want to give back, backup, whatever it is, and then substitute director with hr globally emp.txt. So let us run this command. As we have replaced all the director with hr in the employee.txt, now we only have manager and hr data in the employee.txt. Okay, let us run this command. But first let us see the file. What is the data available we have? We have manager and hr data available in our file. So what exactly we are doing is we are replacing the manager with all the hrs. And of course, we are taking a backup. Now take a listing. I have a file that is employee.txt.back. That is my backup file. And this is the employee.txt where I have replaced all the managers with HR. Let us open this file to cross verify whether the substitution happens or not. So I can see only data related to HR. I cannot see any manager over here, right? That means my substitution is completed. So this is a very practical requirement. Let us open the backup file as well. I have my manager data and HR data. So this is my previous file before substitution. So it's a very practical and very useful requirement. Now what is our next requirement? The next requirement is I want to delete some data from my file on the basis of some pattern. Let's suppose I want to delete the data in my file for directors, right? So what will be the command? The command will be sed and then dash director dash d. This is the context addressing and d stands for delete. So it will delete all the data related to director in that file. Now we will be deleting our data from a file which contains director with the help of context addressing. So this will be the command. Let us copy that command and let's run that command. Sed with context addressing will search director. D stands for delete. It will delete the data from employee2.txt because in employee.txt we have replaced all the directors. So in employee2.txt we have data related to director. Let us first see the file whether we have data related to director or not. Yes, we do have data related to directors. So it will delete the data related to directors. So we have redirected the output into a test.txt file. Let us take a listing and let us see test.txt to cross verify. Now if I try to search director in my test.txt, I will not be able to find data related to directors. Yes, we are not able to find out. That means the data related to director is deleted now. Now what is our next requirement? The next requirement is we want to print everything except a particular pattern. For this we'll use a negate operator. Negate operator is exclamation mark. So what is the requirement over here? I want to print all the data except director. So for that case or for that requirement I have to use a negate operator. Except director, it will print all the data, right? So what will be the command? Sed hyphen n then director except director, it will print all the data and we are redirecting the output into a test2.txt file. So here we are using a negate operator, that is exclamation mark. Let us run this command. So yes, command has run successfully. Let us open that file and see, we cannot find the data for directors. It is giving me only data for manager and HR, except director. Alright. So I hope you have understood the SCD command. If you want to edit any of the file without using any VI editor, then you can use SCD command. That is a stream editor where you just have to pass on the file name and your editing will be done. Apart from SCD command, if you want to learn awk command in Unix, or if you want to learn fastload in Teradata, or if you want to learn TPT in Teradata, or if you want to learn basics of Tableau, then I will give link of all this video into the description box. You can check out in the description box, all the videos are available, or you can check out into the I button, those videos are available over there. You can check out from there and you can learn something new. Alright, if you like this video, then kindly hit the like button, subscribe to our channel Technical Knowledge. We'll keep on posting these technical videos and career guiding and career oriented videos that will be helpful for all of you to grow in your career. Till then, stay at home, be safe, keep learning, keep smiling. Until we meet again, this is Pawan signing off.